Summing data by month in Excel sounds tricky, doesn't it? But it's way easier than you think. By the end of this video, you'll know how to build a formula like this one that lets you calculate monthly sales in just seconds. Hi there, welcome to Productivity Land, the channel where you learn Excel without dying of boredom. Today, we're diving into how to sum data by month in Excel the easy way. The best way to learn Excel is by doing it yourself. So if you want to follow along, there's a link in the description to download the practice sheet I'm using. Let's get started. Picture this. You work at Starbucks and your boss wants you to analyze sales for the pumpkin spice latte, but only for specific months. You've got a table with the dates of each sale and the corresponding amounts, and another table with the months you need to analyze. Let's solve this together using the SUMIF function. In our second table, right next to November in cell F2, we're going to start building the formula. Type equals SUMIF. The SUMIF function requires three arguments. One, the range. This is the range of cells Excel will evaluate to see if each value meets the condition. In this case, it's the dates in column A, so we highlight cells A2 to A11. To make sure this range doesn't change when we copy the formula down, we lock it by adding dollar signs or pressing F4 after selecting it. 2. The criteria. This is the condition that must be met for a cell in the range to be included. Here, we select cell E2, which contains November. This cell doesn't get locked because we want it to change when we drag the formula down to calculate totals for December and January. 3. The sum range. This is the range of numbers that Excel will add up, but only if the corresponding cell in the first range meets the condition. This is the sales data in column B, so we highlight B2 to B11. And just like with the date range, we lock this one too to keep it consistent. Now the formula is ready. Hit enter and we get a zero. Why? Well, even though Excel doesn't show an actual error, the zero is wrong because we know there are sales in November. The issue is that the dates in column A are stored as actual dates, while November in cell E2 is just text. Excel can't compare two things in different formats. To fix this, we need a helper column. In this helper column, we're going to convert the dates into text so Excel can compare them with the condition. In cell C2, type equals text A2MMMM. What does this do? It tells Excel to take the date in A2 and turn it into the full name of the month, like November. The MMM part is the format code for the full month name. If you only need the abbreviation, you can use MMM, which would return something like NOV. This flexibility lets you customize the format to suit your needs. Hit enter and you'll see Excel returns November. Drag this formula down for the rest of the rows, and now you've got a column with the month names in text, perfectly matching our condition. Let's go back to our SUMIF formula to adjust it. First, we change the range to use the helper column instead of the original dates. Highlight C2 to C11 and lock it with F4. The criteria is still cell A2, which we don't lock because it needs to adjust as we drag the formula down. Finally, the sum range stays the same, B2 to B11, and it's already locked. Hit enter and now it works perfectly. Excel adds up all the sales for November. Drag the formula down and it automatically calculates totals for December and January in their respective rows. Finally, YouTube thinks this next video is exactly what you need to become an Excel pro. Click it or you'll keep struggling with your spreadsheets forever. Just kidding! See you there!